Hi, I'm Bridget Brown-Kippett, one of the field application scientists with the genomics division at Agilent. I'm here today to describe how you load the deck of the Magnis NGS Prep System. This is our unit, and we've already selected to run from the touch screen. We are going to select the protocol, so currently we're going to do Sure Select XTHS for Illumina, and we are also choosing the option to get an intermediate QC aliquot. We will click Next by clicking on the right arrow, and it will move to the next screen. On this screen, we will select whether we have high quality or FFPE DNA, as well as the input amount. For today, we will choose high quality, as well as 200 nanograms of input. Click the Next on the arrow, and now we are going to start setting up the deck. The first step is to load the waste bin. You pull out the bin from the instrument and you add the one from the consumables box. These are single use. Make sure that the barcode is facing to the back and that the angle of the bin is so that the larger side is on the right. You put it into the bin and shut the door so that it clicks. We'll click Next. And now we are going to load the heater shaker magnet plate. This is also found in the consumables box. It is located in the back left corner. You're going to want to push it to the left and insert it just as the diagram shows on the touch screen. The one thing that is nice about the touch screen, if you haven't noticed, is that it indicates the direction of the barcodes as you're loading it, as well as the placement on the deck. So we'll click Next. And we're going to actually add the thermal cycler seal. It is also in the consumables box. It comes with a sterile cover with it. So the first thing you need to do is to remove the sterile cover and then insert this into the back right of the Magnis in the thermal cycler until it clicks. We will continue on. The next thing is to add the PCR plate, also found in the consumables box. Will face the barcode to the front, and there's some information when you load this into the deck. You want to make sure that it's level, so we will push to the middle and then the outside four corners. Now we'll click Next. Now we're going to add the three tip boxes. It's very important to remove the lid once you add them, as well as lining up the bottom of the box into the indentations in the deck. So we'll add all three of them as indicated on the touch screen for this protocol. Click Next. Now we are going to add the beads and buffer plate. The beads and buffer plate is located in the refrigerator. You need to pre-warm it for at least 30 minutes, as well as mix it according to the protocol. We've already done that, so we're going to remove it from its cardboard sleeve. Put the barcode towards the front as indicated on the touchscreen, and also note it loads in a similar fashion to the heater shaker magnet. You're going to push it to the left and click it into place. Next, we'll be loading the chiller unit. So we'll have to open the door of the chiller by pushing down on it, releasing the latch, and it opens. Now you have your reagent plate. This reagent plate is in the minus 20 freezer. It also needs to be thawed for about 15 minutes and mixed in a similar manner as indicated in the protocol. There is also the barcode that needs to be facing towards the front, and you put it into the unit in a similar fashion to the way you did the other empty PCR plate. So now that that is loaded, we're going to click Next, and now we're going to add five of our strip tubes. Our strip tubes are colored based on what type of strip tubes they are. So the first thing that we are going to load is the S. This is where you would put your fragmented sample. So the S is purple. It lines up with the purple as indicated in the Magnis, as well as the barcode faces towards you. It's a common theme here. All of the barcodes pretty much face to the front. The next thing we're going to add is the indexes. So the indexes are in a black strip tube. Be sure to note what index you're using. So in this case, we're using A3. It's very important when you're setting up your sequencer. Barcode faces towards you, and you add that where the Magnis indicates the black strip goes. The next one are your probes. Your probes are located in white strip tubes, labeled P, barcode towards you. Place that in the third slot. We'll skip the next slot. Nothing's needed for this protocol. And now you have two strips to add. You have a quality strip that is optional. We indicated when we set up this run, we checked the initial box to get the intermediate QC aliquots. This is the strips that required. If you don't check that box, you don't need to add this strip. So barcode towards us, added into the fifth position. And the last strip is the green strip for your final library. Barcode towards you, added into the sixth position. So you have the three strips, skip one, and then two strips, and that's how the diagram it shows in the magnet. We are going to push down to shut the chiller drawer, make sure that it's shut, and click next. Now we are to close the instrument door. Click next to indicate that we've done that. We need to verify that all of the tip boxes have their lids removed and that they're fully loaded with tips, which they are. Now going through an initializing process where it's going to initialize all the hardware. So it's going through and making sure that the X, Y, and Z accesses are functioning properly, that the thermal cycler is functioning, the heater shaker magnet, and everything to proceed with the protocol. This takes a few seconds to initialize everything, and then we will go through and check to make sure that I've placed all the reagents where they're supposed to be on the deck. So now it's going through and verifying all the labware. So there is a list here on the touchscreen that it's going through. It's checking the thermal cycler seal, then it's checking the PCR plate, the deep well plate for the heater shaker magnet, the tip boxes. What's interesting about the tip boxes is that it's actually scanning for the absence of the barcode. If you notice on the deck for the Magnis, there are the barcodes listed there. And so it's actually scanning to make sure that it's not picking up those barcodes. Everybody else is actually scanning a barcode. So once it does its tip boxes, it will move on to the sample input strip, the index strip, the probe strip, the QC strip, as well as the output strip. So it will go now scanning into the chiller module to scan all of our PCR strips. Click next. So after you click through and verify all of the sample information, you end up with a run setup summary that lists the protocol that you're using, as well as the number of samples, whether or not you indicated for an intermediate QC strip to be completed, as well as the run mode. We'll click the right arrow to continue, and we'll make sure that we've choose the correct sample type. Today we did high quality DNA. The input amount of 200 nanograms, and it also gives you the ability to adjust your pre-capture or your post-capture PCR cycles by clicking one of the pencils to the right. So if we click that, you can indicate what number of cycles you'd like it adjusted to. When you're done, you would push the green arrow to complete the initialization. And the Magnis would actually scan the deck to initialize the run.